Gabapentinoid, Wikipedia Audio. Gabapentinoids, also known as alpha-2-delta ligands, are a class of drugs that are derivatives of the inhibitory neurotransmitter gamma-aminobutyric acid, which block alpha-2-delta subunit containing voltage-dependent calcium channels. This site has been referred to as the gabapentin receptor, as it is the target of the drugs gabapentin and pregabalin. Clinically used gabapentinoids include gabapentin and pregabalin, as well as a gabapentin prodrug, gabapentin enacarbil. In addition, phenibut has been found to act as a gabapentinoid in addition to its action of being a GABA-B receptor agonist. Another analog, mirogabalin, is in clinical trials, but has not yet been approved. Other gabapentinoids which are used in scientific research but have not been approved for medical use include atagabalin, 4-methylpregabalin, and PD-217,014. Gabapentinoids are approved for the treatment of epilepsy, postherpetic neuralgia, neuropathic pain associated with diabetic neuropathy, fibromyalgia, generalized anxiety disorder, and restless legs syndrome. Some off-label uses of gabapentinoids include the treatment of insomnia, migraine, social phobia, panic disorder, mania, bipolar disorder, and alcohol withdrawal. Evidence finds little benefit and significant risk in those with chronic low back pain. Medical uses. Gabapentinoids are ligands of the auxiliary alpha-2-delta subunit site of certain VDCCs, and thereby act as inhibitors alpha-2-delta subunit containing VDCCs. There are two drug-binding alpha-2-delta subunits, alpha-2-delta-1 and alpha-2-delta-2, and the gabapentinoids show similar affinity for these two sites. The gabapentinoids are selective in their binding to the alpha-2-delta VDCC subunit. However, phenibut uniquely also binds to and acts as an agonist of the GABA-B receptor with lower affinity. Despite the fact that gabapentinoids are GABA analogs, gabapentin and pregabalin do not bind to the GABA receptors, do not convert into GABA or GABA receptor agonists in vivo, and do not modulate GABA transport or metabolism. There is currently no evidence that the relevant actions of gabapentin and pregabalin are mediated by any mechanism other than inhibition of alpha-2-delta containing VDCCs. The endogenous alpha amino acids L-leucine and L-isoleucine, which closely resemble the gabapentinoids in chemical structure, are apparent ligands of the alpha-2-delta VDCC subunit with similar affinity as gabapentin and pregabalin, and are present in the human cerebrospinal fluid at micromolar concentrations. It has been hypothesized that they may be the endogenous ligands of the subunit and that they may competitively antagonize the effects of gabapentinoids. In accordance, while gabapentin and pregabalin have nanomolar affinities for the alpha-2-delta subunit, their potencies in vivo are in the low micromolar range, and competition for binding by L-amino acids has been said to likely be responsible for this discrepancy. In one study, the affinity values of gabapentinoids for the alpha-2-delta subunit expressed in rat brain were found to be 0.05 m for gabapentin, 23 m for phenibut, 39 m for phenibut, and 156 m for baclofen. Their affinities for the GABA-B receptor were greater than 1 mm for gabapentin, 92 m for phenibut, greater than 1 mm for phenibut, and 6 m for baclofen. Based on the low affinity of baclofen for the alpha-2-delta subunit relative to the GABA-B, its affinity for the alpha-2-delta subunit is unlikely to be of pharmacological importance. Pregabalin has demonstrated significantly greater potency than gabapentin in clinical studies. Gabapentin and pregabalin are absorbed from the intestines by an active transport process mediated via the large neutral amino acid transporter 1, a transporter for amino acids such as L-leucine and L-phenylalanine. Very few are known to be transported by this transporter. Unlike gabapentin, which is transported solely by the LAT1, pregabalin seems to be transported not only by the LAT1 but also by other carriers. The LAT1 is easily saturable, so the pharmacokinetics of gabapentin are dose-dependent, with diminished bioavailability and delayed peak levels at higher doses. Conversely, this is not the case for pregabalin, which shows linear pharmacokinetics and no saturation of absorption. Similarly, gabapentin inacarbil is transported not by the LAT1 but by the monocarboxylate transporter 1 and the sodium-dependent multivitamin transporter, and no saturation of bioavailability has been observed with the drug up to a dose of 2,800 mg. Similarly to gabapentin and pregabalin, baclofen, a close analog of phenibut, is transported by the LAT1, although it is a relatively weak substrate for the transporter. The oral bioavailability of gabapentin is approximately 80% at 100 mg administered 3 times daily once every 8 hours, but decreases to 60% at 300 mg, 47% at 400 mg, 34% at 800 mg. 33% at 1,200 mg, and 27% at 1,600 mg, all with the same dosing schedule. Conversely, the oral bioavailability of pregabalin is greater than or equal to 90% across and beyond its entire clinical dose range. Food does not significantly influence the oral bioavailability of pregabalin. Conversely, food increases the area under curve levels of gabapentin by about 10%. Drugs that increase the transit time of gabapentin in the small intestine can increase its oral bioavailability. When gabapentin was co-administered with oral morphine, the oral bioavailability of a 600 mg dose of gabapentin increased by 50%. The oral bioavailability of gabapentin inacarbil is greater than or equal to 68%, across all doses assessed, with a mean of approximately 75%. In contrast to the other gabapentinoids, the pharmacokinetics of phenibut have been little studied, and its oral bioavailability is unknown. However, it would appear to be at least 63% at a single dose of 250 mg, based on the fact that this fraction of phenibut was recovered from the urine unchanged in healthy volunteers administered this dose. Gabapentin at a low dose of 100 mg has a Tmax of approximately 1.7 hours, while the Tmax increases to 3 to 4 hours at higher doses. The Tmax of pregabalin is generally less than or equal to 1 hour at doses of 300 mg or less. However, food has been found to substantially delay the absorption of pregabalin and to significantly reduce peak levels without affecting the bioavailability of the drug. Tmax values for pregabalin of 0.6 hours in a fasted state and 3.2 hours in a fed state, and the Cmax is reduced by 25-31% in a fed versus fasted state. In contrast to pregabalin, food does not significantly affect the Tmax of gabapentin and increases the Cmax of gabapentin by approximately 10%. The Tmax of the instant-release formulation of gabapentin inacarbil is about 2.1 to 2.6 hours across all doses with single administration and 1.6 to 1.9 hours across all doses with repeated administration. Conversely, the Tmax of the extended release formulation of gabapentin enacarbil is about 5.1 hours at a single dose of 1,200 mg in a fasted state and 8.4 hours at a single dose of 1,200 mg in a fed state. The Tmax of fenibut has not been reported, but the onset of action and peak effects have been described as occurring at 2 to 4 hours and 5 to 6 hours, respectively, after oral ingestion in recreational users taking high doses. Gabapentin, pregabalin, and fenibut all cross the blood-brain barrier and enter the central nervous system. However, due to their low lipophilicity, the gabapentinoids require active transport across the blood-brain barrier. The LAT1 is highly expressed at the blood-brain barrier and transports the gabapentinoids that bind to it across into the brain. As with intestinal absorption of gabapentin mediated by LAT1, transport of gabapentin across the blood-brain barrier by LAT1 is saturable. Gabapentin does not bind to other drug transporters such as P-glycoprotein and OCTN2. Gabapentin and pregabalin are not significantly bound to plasma proteins. The fenibut analog baclofen shows low plasma protein binding of 30%. Pharmacology. Gabapentin, pregabalin, and fenibut all undergo little or no metabolism. Conversely, gabapentin enacarbil, which acts as a prodrug of gabapentin, must undergo enzymatic hydrolysis to become active. This is done via nonspecific esterases in the intestines and to a lesser extent in the liver. Gabapentin, pregabalin, and fenibut are all eliminated renally in the urine. They all have relatively short elimination half-lives, with reported values of 5.0 to 7.0 hours, 6.3 hours, and 5.3 hours, respectively. Similarly, the terminal half-life of gabapentin enacarbil IR is short at approximately 4.5 to 6.5 hours. The elimination half-life of gabapentin has been found to be extended with increasing doses. In one series of studies, it was 5.4 hours for 200 mg, 6.7 hours for 400 mg, 7.3 hours for 800 mg, 9.3 hours for 1,200 mg, and 8.3 hours for 1,400 mg, all given in single doses. Because of its short elimination half-life, gabapentin must be administered 3 to 4 times per day to maintain therapeutic levels. Similarly, pregabalin has been given 2 to 3 times per day in clinical studies. Fenibut, also, is taken 3 times per day. Conversely, gabapentin enacarbil is taken twice a day and gabapentin XR is taken once a day. The gabapentinoids are 3 substituted derivatives of GABA, hence, they are GABA analogs, as well as gamma amino acids. Specifically, pregabalin is 3-isobutyl GABA, fenibut is 3-phenyl GABA, and gabapentin is a derivative of GABA with a cyclohexane ring at the 3 position. The gabapentinoids also closely resemble the alpha amino acids L-leucine and L-isoleucine, and this may be of greater relevance in relation to their pharmacodynamics. Gabapentin, under the brand name Neurontin, was first approved in May 1993 for the treatment of epilepsy in the United Kingdom, and was marketed in the United States in 1994. Subsequently, gabapentin was approved in the United States for the treatment of postherpetic neuralgia in May 2002. A generic version of gabapentin first became available in the United States in 2004. An extended-release formulation of gabapentin for once-daily administration, under the brand name Gralize, was approved in the United States for the treatment postherpetic neuralgia in January 2011. Pregabalin, under the brand name Lyrica, was approved in Europe in 2004 and was introduced in the United States in September 2005 for the treatment of epilepsy, postherpetic neuralgia, and neuropathic pain associated with diabetic neuropathy. It was subsequently approved for the treatment of fibromyalgia in the United States in June 2007. Pregabalin was also approved for the treatment of generalized anxiety disorder in Europe in 2005, though it has not been approved for this indication in the United States. Gabapentin Enacarbil, under the brand name Horizant, was introduced in the United States for the treatment of restless legs syndrome in April 2011 and was approved for the treatment of postherpetic neuralgia in June 2012. Phenibut, marketed under the brand names Anvifin, Phenibut, and Nufen, was introduced in Russia in the 1960s for the treatment of anxiety, insomnia, and a variety of other conditions. It was not discovered to act as a gabapentinoid until 2015. As of 2017, mirogabalin, under the developmental code name DS5565, is in phase 3 clinical trials for the treatment of neuropathic pain and postherpetic neuralgia. Pharmacodynamics. Pharmacokinetics. Gabapentinoids produce euphoria at high doses, with effects similar to GABAergic central nervous system depressants such as alcohol, gamma-hydroxybutyric acid, and benzodiazepines, and are used as recreational drugs. The overall abuse potential is considered to be low and notably lower than that of other drugs such as alcohol, benzodiazepines, opioids, psychostimulants, and other illicit drugs. In any case, due to its recreational potential, pregabalin is a Schedule V controlled substance in the United States. The United Kingdom is currently in the process of reclassifying gabapentin and pregabalin to Class C controlled drugs due to evidence of abuse, which will make possession without a prescription a criminal offence. However, it is not a controlled substance in the Canada or Australia, and the other gabapentinoids, including phenibut, are not controlled substances either. As such, they are mostly legal intoxicants. Absorption, distribution, metabolism, elimination, chemistry. Tolerance to gabapentinoids is reported to develop very rapidly with repeated use, although to also dissipate quickly upon discontinuation, and withdrawal symptoms such as insomnia, nausea, headache, and diarrhea have been reported. More severe withdrawal symptoms, such as severe rebound anxiety, have been reported with phenibut. Because of the rapid tolerance with gabapentinoids, users often escalate their doses, while other users may space out their doses and use sparingly to avoid tolerance. History. Society and culture. Recreational use. List of agents. Approved. Not approved.